What's up, everybody? Couch Mills here, coming at you with a brand new Valorant video. And in this video, we're gonna talk about what are we supposed to do on pistol rounds now? The classic got nerfed, and that was undoubtedly one of the best weapons in the game, not just for pistol round, but just period. And now that it's nerfed quite a bit, while it's still decent, we need to talk about what are the other options and how do you play out a pistol round. Let's break it all down. We'll go to the Game Leap website right now for in-depth tips and tricks, VOD reviews, map guides, agent courses, and much more. If you want to dominate this act, you got to go check it out right now down below. But without further ado, let's jump to the video. Now, the easy question to ask is, what is the best weapon to be using now? But it's actually a lot more difficult because things are a lot more balanced than they were before. Typically, the classic pistol was your best weapon, and while some number of players could use the ghost, the classic just reigned supreme most of the time, and you almost always won in the head-to-head if you had classic plus armor, if you routed correctly and didn't like take fights from very far away. But that's no longer the case. There's a lot of counterplay now. Specifically, when you're running with the classic, it's not going to be as effective. When you're jumping with the classic, it's not going to be as effective. And that all really matters when you're talking about this really scrappy pistol round. So let's first talk about what is undoubtedly the worst gun to buy in the pistol round, and that's definitely the shorty. The shorty is still the no-go. Stay away from the shorty. Most of the time, the shorty is not a great buy regardless of the round you're in, but it's definitely very bad on that pistol round. Best case scenario, the shorty is gonna allow you to hold a place on defense, and a rifle user is gonna walk in and they're not gonna full clear you. You're gonna kill them and you're gonna get an upgraded gun, right? That's best case scenario. But what's the best case scenario for you on pistol round? If enemies are full rushing, you maybe will get one person, but most of the time you won't even get that single person, because they're all playing around that classic right click, they're distancing themselves away, they're playing around that frenzy, and you might damage some people, but you're probably gonna die, you're gonna get cleared out, and even if you do get somebody, you're really going to be in a terrible situation for retaking and fighting any long distance engagement at all. I literally can't imagine a situation where buying that shorty in pistol round is the correct decision for you to do. Now, let's actually talk about the real competitors for the pistol round now, outside the classic pistol. We'll break that down more in a little bit, but Frenzy versus Ghost is the big question mark. Because while the classic pistol's still gonna be good, it's not going to be as good, especially from those closer ranges and using it with that maximum mobility. And in that department, the Frenzy thrives, and from those longer range engagements, that Ghost pistol thrives. So the classic pistol now kind of is like in the midpoint between that Ghost and the Frenzy, where it's not as effective as the Frenzy for the running and gunning scrappy fights that you would normally want the old classic right click for, but it's definitely far better than the Ghost in that department, and it's not going to be as effective from the longer ranges as the Ghost, of course, but it's far better than the Frenzy in that department. So the classic is kind of in between, quite a little bit depowered from these options, as these are paid options. But specifically, what weapon you choose between the Frenzy and the Ghost, if you choose either of them, is what you're going to be doing in the round, where you're going to be holding, and what character you are. So let's say you want to rush a certain point on pistol round with your team. You could buy something like the Frenzy if you have a way to get in close with your team. Maybe you have a flash, maybe you have some movement ability. So a character like Jett, Raze, maybe even Reyna that uses her flash to get in. These are characters that not only can get in with that Frenzy, but specifically a character like Reyna greatly benefits from being able to kill someone with the Frenzy, because getting that full shield when you have a Frenzy is going to be ridiculous to actually challenge if you are a Reyna with that Frenzy. But ultimately, the Ghost is probably going to be more used than the Frenzy, and what we're going to see more of immediately is an uptick in the Ghost pick rate. Now, this is specifically not going to contest people that were buying, or rather not buying, a classic pistol plus all their abilities, right? This is not going to change because those people wanted to buy all their abilities anyways, and the classic pistol, while it's weaker, it's still comparable. They really want their abilities more than they want extra firepower. But the Ghost is going to look a lot better when you compare it to the alternative, which is that classic pistol plus that light armor. Now, it's less reliable to brute force your way into these aggressive positions where you can right click, jump right click, run right click with this classic pistol and get guaranteed value. And the Ghost is looking a lot better, but it's still very important that the Ghost user, if you are buying a Ghost, you're still distancing yourself away from enemies, because that classic right click can still do quite a bit of damage to you. If there's two of them, you're gonna get traded out very easily, and the Frenzy is still going to be way more effective with that close range running and gunning and things like that. Until you identify what weapons enemies have, you should make sure to distance appropriately with that Ghost pistol. Now, the last weapon that we really need to talk about is that Sheriff. And Sheriff is a weapon that is always something that people could whip out in ranked for no reason at all. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's good and it would be played in pro play, but that doesn't matter for ranked. People want to use the Sheriff, they're going to whip out that Sheriff. Now, we just talked about how there's probably going to be a decrease in that light shield plus classic pistol pick rate, which is actually a mark against the Sheriff. Because one of the big benefits to the Sheriff in comparison to the Ghost in the previous pistol meta was that the classic pistol plus armor could still get one-shot headshotted by the Sheriff when it couldn't get one-shot headshotted by the Ghost. So that's just something to keep in mind. The Sheriff is going to be a fair bit worse than it was previously, and it's going to be really rare for characters to want to use the Sheriff at all if they want to do it for trying to win, right? If you're doing it for style's sake, yeah, sure, whatever. But specifically trying to win the most amount of pistol round, most of the time, some amount of abilities are going to be 100% needed on every single character. That being said, the one exception that has even seen play in pro play would be Killjoy on attack on certain maps where you still get that turret, you just don't need all your other utility. You're using the turret to guard flank, and then you're gonna buy that Sheriff, and it can be pretty decent on the longer sight lines. But that is a very niche scenario, and honestly, the Sheriff is probably gonna take a backseat to Frenzy's Ghosts and just even the classic pistol without armor. Now, strategy that I think could actually be pretty powerful, specifically in ranked play, if you and a buddy wanted to try this out, is get someone to buy a Reyna, a Frenzy, when the Reyna buys light armor. Now, this is something that a lot of pro teams have done in the past. In my VOD reviews, I've spectated this, and I think it's actually primed to get even stronger. If you give that Reyna that freaking light armor and frenzy, she can't get one-shotted. You route in really close, and she's probably going to be able to take sight control just completely free. It's actually really, really powerful. Now, granted, one person has to buy the Reyna the Frenzy, so they're giving up quite a bit of credits, but if we go back to that Killjoy example, the Killjoy could just not buy a Sheriff, and if they're not buying that many abilities anyways, they could just buy, you know, something else, just a few abilities instead, and give up a Frenzy to a Reyna. Now, ultimately, does the classic pistol still slap? Is it very powerful, or is it super, super weak now? Well, the classic pistol's actually not that bad. I mean, you gotta remember that this is a goddamn free weapon, right? It's not something that you had to pay for. It doesn't need to do everything, right? But it's still going to be really good at finishing off people. You're still going to be able to get at least one pellet on a target if you jump and you aim at center mass. So that's going to finish off very, very low targets. And that's still the same if you're moving and things like that. So while it's a lot less accurate, you're not going to be able to get multiple headshots with it anymore while you're running and jumping. You're still going to be able to finish off low targets. And then you can still use the classic pistol like you would every weapon with actual counter strafing to hit people when you're close to them fairly accurately, or just use your primary fire. And the classic is gonna be fine. Like, it's a fine weapon, but a lot of the ways that you could abuse it before were some of the best ways to completely counter ghost users, and I think that these nerfs really affected it in the right ways. If a ghost user actually distances correctly, it's gonna be really hard for the classic pistol user to finesse them like they did before. Now, of course, the new agent chamber is definitely gonna be a completely unknown entity in those pistol rounds when he comes out in 2 weeks, because he gets to buy that light armor plus 4 bullets in a Sheriff, which kind of could mess up a lot of things depending on how much he's played. We don't know how popular he's gonna be after the dust settles. Of course, right off the bat, he's gonna be picked a lot, and the pistol meta will shift around him for a little while. But we'll be doing a future update video talking about his impact on the meta for ranked play. So if you want to see that, you gotta smash that like and subscribe. But go to the GameLeap website for in-depth tips and tricks, VOD reviews, map guides, agent courses. We're gonna be doing an in-depth agent course full on chamber, so go check that out right now down below if you want to get ahead on the action. But thank you so much for coming by. Hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you hydrate, and I'll see you next time, baby.